Hey folks, Edgar B. Herbuck III here from GBH's Curiosity Desk, where you ask questions and I find answers. Today we're at the famed Massachusetts Institute of Technology, where thanks to a question from New Hampshire's Lorraine von Snydern, we are literally chasing rainbows.
My question is, why are the rainbows that I see outside after a rainstorm always a perfect arc?
Rainbows are, of course, one of nature's most charming tricks of light, and light is exactly what scientist Mathias Kolle spends his days pondering. In order for a rainbow to appear in the sky, you need three ingredients, so to speak: sunlight, raindrops, and you. And as Kolle explains, all three have to be in a very particular spot for the magic to happen.
So the sun has to be behind you.
Okay.
That's the first thing, there's sun behind you. Then there has to be water in the atmosphere in front of you. And that's usually when it rains, you get the condition, right? And then what you also want to do is you want to look at the right spot.
These positions are critical because of the two phenomena responsible for the appearance of a rainbow. A couple of old friends you might remember from middle school: refraction and reflection. Refraction is responsible for a rainbow's colors. When sunlight enters a raindrop, it bends. White light, like sunlight, is comprised of a spectrum of colored light. Now, each color is at a slightly different wavelength and bends at a slightly different angle when it enters the droplet.
All of a sudden, we get the splitting of colors, where the reds and the oranges and the greens and the blues go in slightly different directions.
After the light enters the raindrop and is split into its component colors, a small portion of it reflects off the back and heads in a new direction. With each color now on a slightly different path, it refracts one more time as it's leaving the droplet and heads back down toward the Earth at a very precise angle. 40 degrees for the red, about 42 degrees for the violet, with the other colors in between. And that's just one raindrop. All of this is happening at an incredible scale, with literally billions of rays of light hitting billions of raindrops.
It happens in every raindrop, as long as it sees the ray of sun. It will do that refraction, reflection, refraction thing. But if you're not standing in the right position, you will not see this by most of the raindrops.
But if you are in the right position, that magic angle between 40 and 42 degrees, there will be raindrops galore, throwing innumerable beams of distinct red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet light right at you. And the raindrops that are at that perfect angle relative to the sun and you form a distinct shape.
All the droplets that are on this arc are going to send the light in the right direction for me to catch it.
So we have to think about it three-dimensionally, right? So it's like this.
Exactly.
And my elbows kind of my eyes in
Your elbows would be your eyes in the scenario, exactly. Yeah.
You can think of it like a cone, with you at the point and the rainbow appearing along the circumference of the base. Now, as for why the entire circumference doesn't light up like a rainbow, well, the ground gets in the way. If you could get up high enough so that there's a lot of rain below your feet, well, Kolle says, imagine you're Jack on a beanstalk.
And as he climbs up, this arc would actually shift with him, but extend further and further below and start to actually, once it's in half arc, start to arc back on itself. And as he climbs higher and higher, this arc might close. And all of a sudden you don't have an arc, but you have a circle.
A rain circle.
A rain circle. Not a rainbow anymore, a rain circle.
And if you think rain circles are cool, consider this. All of those individual raindrops that are making the rainbow that you see are unique to your position, and they're changing constantly, moment to moment. So forget about leprechauns and pots of gold. The real magic is in the science and the fact that anytime you see one, you are literally standing in the center of your own personal rainbow. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and perhaps most importantly, let me know what you are curious about, because no matter how colorful the question, I might look into it for you. I'm Edgar B. Herbuck III. Stay curious out there.
Oh,
tasty rainbow. It's not vomit, it's a rainbow.
The Curiosity Desk is sponsored by Emerson College, inspiring curiosity and creative expression in all of us.